Calico County, like some 26 million people out of the county that filed unemployment. That's a lot of people out here.
That say, oh man, like me, I was so low. Was love, but now I see 'twas grace that tore my heart to be. The I first believed when we bathed 10,000 years, bright shining. Then when we first begun, amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved. Was love, but now I see.
Let us bow our heads in prayer. Lord, dear gracious God, we thank you for the strength, for the love, for the help in these trying times. Lord, we thank you for you told us in your word that you was acquainted with our grief and you bore our sorrow. Lord, I'm asking that you would let your comfort encamp around about the family today and throughout the days to come. Let them know, God, that they can rest assured in your love and your faith. Amen. To help them get through these trying times. These precious things we ask in the name of Jesus. Let everyone say, amen. Scripture that comes to mind today that I would like to read, it's just a very familiar passage of scripture. It's Psalms 23. It says, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For thou art with me, thy rod and staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. In the house of the Lord forever. Kathy Jines, 61, of New Whiteland, passed away on April the 20th, 2020. She was born on November the 23rd, 1958, in Indianapolis, Indiana, to Paul and Ruby Beasley. She was a member of The Church of Jesus Christ Apostolic Faith. Kathy had been fighting cancer since 1983. She fought cancer at the age of 25 and then breast cancer at the age of 40. She loved everyone she met, but especially her children, grandchildren, and great-grandchildren. She loved to go to the casinos. That was her thing to do, and to travel and to dance and karaoke. And I'm going to put in there, she always liked to go to church when she got the chance. She always wanted to help people out in any way she could. Her family was her passion, and survivors include her three children, Jeremy and Angela Hayes, Jacqueline Hayes, and Josh Hayes, five grandchildren and seven great-grandchildren. Also surviving are her five siblings, Paul and Becky Beasley, Barb and Don Majors, Kevin and Cheryl Beasley, and Ricky and Anita Beasley, and Tina Kelso. She was preceded in death by her parents, Paul and Ruby Beasley, and her brother James Beasley. As I was just at home yesterday, which we ain't been able to really go nowhere too much, and I began to think and was asking the Lord some things to say today, he brought my mind, took my mind, should I say, way back. And I asked someone this morning, I couldn't remember what year it was, but I remember it was New Year's Eve night. We had just prayed the old year out and the new year in, and we had went to IHOP to get breakfast when we got a phone call that Kathy had had an aneurysm on the brain and they wasn't expecting her to live. We got to the hospital and of course the doctor wanted to pull the plug. And I said, is she brain dead? He said, no. I said, well, as long as there's life, there's still hope. Every day, Mother White would go to that hospital, hold Kathy's hand, and pray every day. God gave us a miracle, and that was January of 2009. This is 2020. You know, they said she'd be a vegetable. She wouldn't be able to walk. She wouldn't be able to talk, Jeremy. But look what God did. Never forget the time that she was at Barb's and she'd go through therapy. And I'll never forget that one time she raised that arm up like this to show me. I'd come up the sidewalk. She was showing me she could lift her arm up. Then when she'd get from there and she was able to walk with her Hemi walker, you know, she just really trying to show out and just do it real fast. But I'll never forget a time she came to church. She loved coming to church. And every time she would, she'd be singing. One time she testified, tears rolling down her face, thanking the Lord for sparing her and saving her life. She was always thanking God. The last day that I saw her alive, we was with her, and I had prayed for her, and I had told her, Kathy, God loves you. She said, and I love him too. Of course, there was a few other things she said. Always teased her. She told me I'd never let her live it down about her fixing a grilled cheese sandwich and slapping me on the arm with the butter knife. Burning my arm, and then Barb put drawing salve on it. And then Barb said, yeah, it's doing what it's supposed to do. It's drawing the fire out. I said, yeah, it's drawing the fire out. It's killing me. She said, you're never going to let me live that down. I said, well, no. Remember who I am. I'm Pat the Rat. Of course, she said, Pat the Rat, of course. But I'm thankful for the times of life. I was just a few months older than she was, and we'd always tease each other about, you know, I was older than she was. But I'm thankful because she never forgot about God. She always loved to sing. She always was a very loving person. As it had already been said, she would help out others and do without herself. That was just the love she had, which reminds me of her mother. Thankful for our loving and caring family. And I have always had a thing that I would say when I would do marriage, but I'm going to instill it today. We should never hold grudges against one another. We should never go around hating one another. Because we may not know when our last chance will be that we can tell somebody, I'm sorry. Forgive me. We find that God is that God that will always go with us. He's always a forgiving God. He's a loving God. He's a compassionate God. In these trying times and hours that we're living in, there's so many things that we haven't been able to do and so many things that has been going on, not being able to have church like we usually have church, not being able to visit one another like we used to visit. But we should always love and care for one another. I want to instill into you today, the Bible says it like this, as a tree falleth, so does it lie. We live our life here on earth, and how we live our life today is how God judges us according to our life here on earth. And these particular times and trying times that we are going through, I'm just going to be plain. I feel like it's a warning from God. The Lord is soon to come. You can still maybe not have an actual service in a church building, but you can still go and call on the Lord still in your place of repentance where you want to talk to God. And he's still there to hear and to listen. If I say anything else, it'd be like this. Don't come and let him catch you with your work undone. I love you. If I didn't, I wouldn't tell you. Because God is coming in an hour when we think not. And a lot of people, you know, they think, well, church folks is old fogies and they're crazy and the Lord's not coming, but he's still coming. That's one thing he promised in his word, that he's coming. And another thing he promised in his word for us today, Josh and Jacqueline and Jeremy and Barb and Ricky and Paralf, Kevin, the family. He said, I'll go with you always, even to the end. We'll be going today as far as we can go with Kathy. but God will still go with us beyond that. He said, make your calling and election sure. God loves each one of us. He came to seek and to save that which was lost. And I'm so grateful and so thankful for his love that he shed his blood on Calvary over 2,000 years ago that you and I might be saved. In closing, I just want to say, don't put off your salvation. We look and we see of the trying times. And God is still allowing us to be here on the face of the earth. He's given us time. He said time and chance happens to us all. And he said it's appointed unto man once to die. And then after that is the judgment. I love you. I love you as my family. I love you as friends. Most of all, God loves you. And that's what Kathy remembered. He said, she said, and I love him. Because he first loved us. Said, no greater love hath no man than this, that he laid down his life for his friend. God loves us when we weren't even lovable. He loved us. And he still loves us. He looks beyond all of our faults. And he sees that we have need of him. God is not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance, to everlasting life. Let us bow our heads. Lord, dear gracious God, Lord, we thank you for your love, your caring that you gave to us as you went to the old rugged cross on a hill far away. You shed your blood that we might have life and that we might have it more abundantly. Lord, I'm asking you to go with us today and through the days ahead. Lord, I ask you to fill the voids in our lives that we are going to have with this loved one that we have just lost. But Lord, I'm so grateful and so thankful for a chance to still know that you're God and that you told us in your word you was a very present help in the time of trouble. Lord, I ask you to go with us today in the family. Lord, strengthen us, uphold us with your free spirit, comfort us, and give us strength that we stand in the need of, and we'll be gracious to you. These blessings we ask in Jesus' name. Let everyone say, amen.
Glad morning when this life is over. I'll fly away to a home on God's celestial shore. I'll fly away. I'll fly away. Oh, glory. I'll fly away. When I die, hallelujah, by and by. To